West Virginia starts the season in the 12th spot.
It's nice to be in the top 25, but this team wants a bigger piece of the pie. Stringing together some big wins at the start will put them in position to run with the big dogs.
And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
The matchup in the small forward position should be entertaining. Two good young men who often turn some heads at the wing position.
And tonight we've got the opportunity to see great college basketball. Two power teams ranked in the top 25 and both looking to make their mark and come out on top.
I think it's going to be a tough, tough game. You have two teams that leave it on the floor and can get after it. Both coaches do a good job preparing their teams. It's now up to the players to go out there and execute.
Number 25 comes up with it. Now on the run. For the Bucks, count the basket. It was going down. Both teams looking to get things going here. The shooting guard takes the feed. Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner. Missed the jumper. Goes up for two. He gets the shot to fall. Number five handles the pass.
Block shot usually creates momentum and opportunities.
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Number five picks up the foul. First team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, by the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's a matter of bringing it every day.
Second one, no good. Number one with the ball. He tries the three ball. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Number 14 with the ball. Number 21 is called for the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
And there's a look at the young freshman.
You know, playing at this level can be a tough adjustment for some kids. Others make the jump look easy. It all depends on what kind of team you have around you and how hard you are willing to work to get better.
The center receives the ball, looks at a three, busts the jumper. They work it around the perimeter. In the lane. Jumper won't go. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Puts up the jumper. Nails the J. They had the great defense. On the left side. He shoots from outside. Can't connect. Loose ball save. For two. Misses from in close. Tries for two. He makes the shot. When you can pass and score like he does, it makes a coach's job a little bit easier, wouldn't you say, Dick?
Hey, when the scorer is able to read and react to pressure like this, holes start showing up in the defense.
For the bucket, off the glass and no good. Goes up for two. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
On the outside. For two. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. Rebound out. He comes up empty. Blocked! Nice job defensively. Man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, It's well-executed two-man game is always a treat to watch.
On the outside, number 31 is whistled for the foul. First team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He's usually hit and miss from the stripe, Dick.
So much of it's mental, Brad.
Makes the first. He misses the second shot. Pushes it up. Tries for two. For two. Tipped in.
What a great tip. What a great second effort.
Number five takes the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land.
Excellent jump shot right there.
About 6 minutes remaining. Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that.
That layup will count for two, plus the harm.
Hey, he sized the defender up and protected the ball going in for the layup. Boy, was that beautiful.
As we take a look at the sophomore.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches.
He tries the jumper. And nice looking jumper in the lane. Looking for a good shot. Turnover by the freshman. The small forward with the ball. They look to get it to the inside. He shoots from the corner. Questionable shot selection there.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
Number 25. The layup's good and one, Dick.
Hey, that's good concentration. Taking the ball hard to the hoop. Knowing that someone's going to hack you.
He'll visit the charity stripe. He sinks it. Number 25 handles the feed. There's a bad pass right to the defender. They work the perimeter. For the bucket, he hits the shot. He cut back door and the pass was delivered perfectly.
Terrific pass. That's great timing. Put the defense sleeping. A great backdoor pass.
Nope. On the dribble, gives it up. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
They're off into transition. Goes up for two. No good from the field.
Gotta take some pride on a defensive end. Up and inside.
For two. He can't get the bucket to fall. That one's off. From three-point land. Knocks it down. Gave it up. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turn around, fadeaway. Moving it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Makes it. Did a great job of getting to the hoop on that one, Richard.
Great job of using the bounce to get to the rim. Not too many defenses that can stop that move.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Missed it. Who'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick?
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you get the points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
2 physical. He gets the layup to go and the foul.
What a hoop. He saw the defender coming and tried to go right through him.
with the freebie. There's a reason they're called free throws. Number one takes the feed. Takes the jumper. Bust the J. We're at the 3 minute mark. Inside. With the J. Off the mark. The small forward gets the pass. Lobs it for the buck with a rejection. And the ball is saved. Great job. Now on the run. He throws it up from downtown. Jumper won't go. From right in the circle and come up short. Number 25 handles the pass. Jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Throws it up. Goes up for two. Drains it. Coach providing some additional offensive instruction to his team. Cross court. For two. Goes. About 2 minutes remaining. Now they'll bring it up. Number 21 takes it away. Number 5 fakes the shot. He launches a three. Off the mark. Pushes it up. Tries for two. He nails the shot. Pushes it up. He tries the three. They get it to go. One minute left on the game clock. Number one with the and a chance to make it a three-point play.
Yeah, good second effort to stay with it right there. Did a great job attacking the defense.
He goes to the line. Misses the free one. This team has got to be so frustrated. They are terrible at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Frustration only makes it worse, Brad. They have to figure out what they're doing wrong and fix it.
For the bucket, perfectly executed.
Look at that spacing.
He shoots the jumper. Can't connect. Shot clock is dead. He shoots from a deep corner. Knocked it down. Who wants it? And he saves it. Number three steals the ball. Now in transition. Fed the low block. Trying to beat the buzzer. The basket's gonna count, and we're going to overtime.
College basketball at its best, baby. Now you can see why I love it. We'll be in overtime.
At the half, the Mountaineers are up by 15. Number 14 hasn't really weathered the storm in the first half. He's really only had an average half, and their team is way behind.
I wouldn't worry too much, Brad. Don't be surprised to see the offense go through it more often in the second half. If there's anyone who can get them out of this bind, it's him.
Number 14 is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
Looks like they're going to go with a full-court man-to-man press, Dick. There's the block. Sinks the shot.
Pushing that basketball.
And it's dripped. Active hands. Number three takes the feed. For two, he drains the shot. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Missed the jumper. Number one gets the pass. He shoots from left of the circle. Missed it.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have delicate guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. Looks at the three. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
From right in the circle, gets the J to fall. Dick at defense looks tired.
Hey, that's no excuse. They've got to dig down deep and get the job done.
He goes up with it. Nope. Rebound out. Tries for two. Tickles a twine. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
For the bucket. Sinks it. They get an open look for three. The missed shot. On the right side. He wants a three. Nails the J. Way out on the right wing. Trying to pack it inside. Goes up for two. Gets it to go. The Yellow Jackets did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
You know, whether you're attacking the zone or man-to-man, getting the ball into the high post puts pressure on the defense.
And we've got a change in possession here. We're at the 7 minute mark. There's a double team waiting there. Number one picks up the foul. Third personal foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
They work it around the perimeter. From the corner. And score it. He shoots from the top of the key. In and out. Number three takes the feed. On the dribble, gives it up. They go with the entry pass. On the post, turnaround jumper.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For two, got it. This is the type of guy that can throw the whole kitchen sink at you if you're not careful.
I'll tell you one thing, Mr. Nestler. He's worked hard to develop a variety of post moves. Just a complete post play.
His bad. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
On the left side. Dumps it in. Tries for two. They get it to go. About 6 minutes remaining on the game clock. They'll work it around the arc. He shoots from the corner. Jumper won't go. It's heading out of bounds. No, great save. These guys have really been able to step it up so far, and they're putting together a very good team effort.
I tell you what, they get an A for effort in my book so far, Brad. Sometimes that's the hardest thing to get from your team as a coach. When you have everyone on your team working together and playing hard, great things work out.
Down inside. He attempts the jump shot. Knocked it down. bucket. He nails the bucket. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Number three takes the pass. For two. That was nice. We're at the 5 minute mark. Looking for a good shot. Blocked!
Frustration right there.
Tries for two. He buries the shot. Out on the right wing with a bucket. Scorches the net. Jumper. Scorches the net with a J. Pushes it up. He puts up the J. Off the mark. From the corner.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The Mountaineers are known for playing in the half court, so at this point in the game, things are really looking good for them.
Brad, I don't care what style of play a team usually applauds, but at this point, and with the lead, they must milk the clock.
The point guard takes the feed. The Yellow Jackets might be in a bit of trouble here, Dick. They're an up-tempo team, but they've really got to take their play to another level right now.
They need to get down and dirty, Brad. They should start pressing and trapping in order to force some turnovers. Time is definitely not on their side.
Gave it up. Goes up with it. Missed the jump. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
They got it. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Working it around the perimeter. Puts up the shot. Off the backboard. From right at the circle. Can't get the shot to drop. Goes up for two. Tries for two. Tipped in.
What a great tip. What a great second effort.
Two minutes left on the game clock. For two. Off the glass and no good. Trying to feed the low block with a great block. Bust the J. Fans are pleased now, given the fact that this game is really out of reach.
It's almost an expectation, Brad. You're supposed to win your home games, but winning by this amount, my goodness.
Top of the key. Number 31 is called for the foul. First team foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
He steps up to the line. Hits the first.
Drained it. Nothing but nylon. NBA.
Pushes it up. He shoots from the deep corner. The friendly bounces aren't going their way at the moment, Dick.
They need to get some easier looks, Brad.
He tries the jumper. Scores it. Pushes it up. From way outside.
Excellent jump shot right there.
The power forward receives the pass. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Loose ball, saves it. Great play. They run it up into transition for the bucket.
Good score out of transition, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up. He tries to knock down the three. Gets the J to fall. Pushes it up. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Number zero gets the ball. Goes up with a shot. The missed shot. Out on the wing. Let's it fly. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Number five comes in for his first go-round tonight.
I'll tell you, the offense doesn't miss a beat when this guy comes in.
He shoots from the top of the circle. He misses from the outside. On the left side. He goes for three. Knocks it down. Pushes it up. Launches the three. Gets the J to fall. Pushes it up. He puts up the tray. West Virginia wins tonight in a blowout.
After a game like that, it's hard to believe that these two teams were close in the standings.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.